Well, guys, seems like for now, for a while, this will be the last video of Gona Matt and Nisa. So take a good look. We've been through a lot the last few months. They were very, very slow to grow in captivity, but one of the most ferocious larvae I've ever reared. Their spines are so sharp and they'll get everywhere in your skin, and they're just horrible. But they are also extremely pretty and fascinating. But I'm very glad that they are pupating now. It took me 4 months' time to rear them to this size. And some are over 14 centimeters long. So they are one of the largest caterpillars I've seen, next to some Citronia and maybe Atlas moth larva. Very impressive agar moths, Lasiocampidae. And wow, as you can see, I still have quite a few larvae left, but they're spinning up, which is evident because here we see a fresh cocoon. Let's try and get a close-up, right? Maybe I have to take this leaf away. Here, we have a fresh cocoon. And it's covered with the spines of the larvae have too. And these spines are actually very razor sharp, they feel like broken glass. These caterpillars are worse than any Automerus or Dervia or Lonomia that I have ever bred. And that says something, I will never forget them. What an experience. And for the ones that love agar moths, I have eggs coming up of a new species. Of course, it's not going to be Gonomata, but it's a similar species to this. But this time it's not from Africa. This time it will be from Taiwan. So I'm quickly going to change their container soon. And I think in quite a while, in a few weeks maybe, all of them will be in the cocoons, and that's quite nice. So for now, this will be the last video of Gona Matt and Nisa. That is until the adults come out, of course. Here are some caterpillars. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned. There's a lot coming up this year.